Okay, so okay. We're recording now. My name is Hallur Sævarsson. I'm from Iceland, but I live in Denmark, and I'm with my very good friend Thomas Kristensen, and we are today going to go through a match which I played against my fellow Icelandic countryman Stefan Freyr in an championship, Icelandic Championship, which is playing now online, and we play a triple elimination tournament up to 13, and we're going to go through this match move by move and talk about yes. What I thought and in interesting positions, and we'll comment on game plans and strategies, and we'll try to keep it at a level where everybody can understand. And
sure.
Yep.
Yeah. Let's see what happens.
All right. Cool. So we have opening here 5-2, which is playing itself more or less.
Standard 5-2.
Standard. And 5-2 here, when you have this split, you often just duplicate the move.
You actually have a choice. Yeah, I think actually in money game you play two down because the 6-4 is duplicated. If you maybe put up the this one,
yeah,
you can see sure. If you play it like this, uh-huh. it's not so bad as it looks because the 6-4 for black is. He wants to make the bar point, but he also wants to hit on the 14.
Yeah.
So it's duplicated. So it's a toss up between these two. This is more aggressive,
yeah.
But the other one is fine as well to split.
And perhaps many, beginners would consider double hitting here, which is not the right move.
Yeah, you don't want to put a check on the ace point. That's strip the eight point. That's pretty bad.
If you got a 3-2, it would be different because then you would
a 3-2. I think you would hit and play
and
down
play
to
down
the
down
11, 11. Still not double hit. Still not put a check on the ace point so early.
So Stefan is black here and he rolls a 5-3, which of course puts a man on the bar.
It's a good roll.
Good roll. 2-6. You
two.
Enter and go out.
Yeah.
Standard. 5-3 here is a bit interesting because he has some options here. Playing out, which he did from behind, or playing just down and split the.
It's a bit of an awkward roll, I would say. It's you're leading the race by 8 pips, no 11 pips after the roll, and you basically want to, get your checkers home. On the other hand, you have the stronger board, it's just a bit of an awkward roll. So you could come out to the 16, which he did, or you could play stop on the 21 point and play down to the 8.
I think I might do that. XG here actually likes to slot the 5,
which
I couldn't find that. I think
that's
a
computer.
That's
a
computer move.
but it actually makes some sense because.
Duplicates the threes
and also when you have the two towers, as I like to call them, on the 6 and 8, you don't want to be on the 20 and the 21 point.
That's true.
So
it's close.
Yeah.
He runs out from behind, which is fine. I get a 2-6, which is also very awkward. Actually, an anti joker here. And consideration here is, you can't hit, you can't make, the midpoint here. What options are you? Do you have like running from the 18, or playing to 16 and not getting a direct, 6-2 shot, and playing down, and then you duplicate actually the 4. So I think I remember from the match I took a long time thinking of this.
Yeah, it's often correct to duplicate the 4s in the opening phase if you can, but here I guess
why is it good to duplicate the 4s?
It's often a role that's or a number that's constructive for the opponent in many different areas of the board. So if you can duplicate it, it's you cut down on his good rolls.
And you cross your fingers he doesn't get
double force. Exactly. But here, I guess duplicating the force as you did by playing to the, can we put it up? Playing to the,
yes, of course.
The 16 and the seven.
Yes.
It's a bit of a problem that you play with three blocks. You create a third block,
and he has
and,
a stronger board.
And mm-hmm. you do what I like to call semi-strip the
not
midpoint. You rather want four checkers on the midpoint than three.
Yeah.
And so the alternative is just to play all the way to the 10, which is
looks more natural and only one.
Also a single shot. You don't duplicate anything, but. Of course,
and you are also threatening to make something more, you know, constructive in your home board, I would say.
And you play,
but it's close.
It's not
as bad as it.
It's pretty close.
All right, so top, he gets his four, but he's also gets a six four. So this is very interesting because he has many options here.
Yeah, that's the advantage of duplicating the force. Now he's in doubt now what to do. He can make an error, which he did.
Yeah.
But it's also not so easy because you want to hit on the 18. That's the chair you want to hit because, but then you don't really have a good six.
So if you
hit on the 18, then you should maybe hit on deuce or something.
Yeah.
So look at it, but it's a bit awkward to put a barrier checker on the deuce.
Often you don't want to hit loose, like, you know, on the 2 point if there's no really need to it.
Yeah,
know?
Exactly.
So
instead he made a kind of an anchor on the 16, which is good. He's leading the race and he hit the 9. It's a natural play.
Yeah.
But there's something even stronger, which is to blitz.
Yeah.
And that's, I think it's
would you have
partly it? Due to, I don't know, I would have looked at it.
It's due to
the three blots, I guess. Mm. And if we can put on the dice distribution, I don't know if it will show on the...
No, it will not show actually on
but
the...
But what you can see from the dice distribution, if you make the... If you blitz and... You give him nine rolls to fan, and you can
do you play on too good?
You're almost too good if he fans.
Okay.
It's a pass for sure.
I think it's a huge pass. Of course,
it's a huge pass. So it's just very very good to give your opponent nine horrible rolls.
Yeah.
This wins more games, what he played, but it's less effective with the cube,
what
I guess.
What about in DMP?
In DMP, I would play this.
Yeah, wins more games, the other one wins more gammons, and that is also correct. You can see it here, the wins, you have 66% wins and 28% gammons if you do the, if you make the 2 point and put in one, the check with a 3 point board. And loses a little bit more, but what he played wins more and of course less gammons. So in DMP that would be the correct move. So let's move on. I enter and go down and make the
natural play.
So actually here
he could consider cubing here.
He is now leading by. With 12 pips, he has come from behind with the backman, and you he has a threat to, you know, roll some really good numbers.
I think this is a case of many small advantages becomes one big one because as you said he's leading by 12 pips, which is already quite a substantial lead, and he has the stronger board.
Yeah.
He has some attack. He has like
so he has
6, 10 checkers in the zone.
Lots of, you know, advantages here.
Exactly. And he
lots
has
of pros,
he has escaped. He has the 16 points. So he has a lot going for him and a lot of rolls or some rolls that lose the market.
I'm stripped on the...
Yeah, you don't really have anything yet. You have the bar point, but it's not so useful, and you don't have a board.
And it's not, and it's a little bit, you know, I would have doubled just, you know, to check if the opponent actually drops it. It is a huge stake still.
That's a good point.
But I think, you know,
there's also a chance that your opponent might pass.
Yeah, exactly.
Of course, it is still quite an easy take since you're not on the bar and you still have a decent race.
Yeah.
And you're not under so much attack, but no. You should clearly double because of the super rollers, super jokers like double fours and double twos.
Yeah. So, 5-2 or something like that, or 4-2 and a fan, that would, you know, be, how do you say, pass the market or lose the market?
Yeah. Would lose the market on some sequences.
Let's move on, and he gets a 2-1, and he has an option of picking and passing here. But he makes what I probably also would have done, you know, not, you know, I don't know, putting a man behind, you know,
on the three point, and
makes some jokers from him and just make the natural 7 point.
You're not desperate to hit here.
This is strong. This is strong. And if I don't roll a 2 or something soon to get a anchor, I'm really in the danger of getting doubled here.
Good roll.
I get a 2 and make the anchor, of course, and I play to the 3, which is very natural.
That's natural.
6-2. This is actually a bit interesting because he needs to give a shot because you don't want to open the, you know, the prime, so to say, and put a man behind there. So say playing safe here is not an option in my book. So
he could play the very ugly 13-7, 3-1. Maybe look at that.
Oh yeah, okay, yes, this one, okay.
You could play this.
I'm sorry, you also have this one here, which is, you know,
it's
safe, kind of, but it's not
safe,
you know,
but it's
you're destroying your board and you want to have like something, and I don't know.
It's a bit too ugly. Also because this is the kind of play you could play if you were leading like by a huge amount and your opponent had a really strong board.
It's 16 pips, so you are, you know, in a decent race, of course. So keep the board. And he plays, which I like, 16-8, taking the chance now of, you know, giving a shot while I don't have the board.
Yeah, it's kind of a pay now situation. And
so
and he also duplicates your force to hit and to cover the 3 point. So good play.
And it's a good play. So the very close, you know, candidate here, according to XD, is playing 2 down.
Yeah, that's also
it's good, you know, you get checkers to make the
and you keep the anger. Good play.
Double 3. So when you get a double, often you take a long time considering and you just built the board here. You don't want to go down here, and you don't do that now. Also, you're behind in the race, and you keep that.
It's okay.
What do you call it? Mid? Do you call it
the midpoint?
The midpoint
is good to keep.
Exactly.
So also it makes it a little more difficult for his blood to get to safety.
So you have some variations here, which are very close to XD, and I play this one where I maximize getting
it's
the front board.
It's difficult to say what's best.
6-3, it's a good roll.
Good roll
you make.
It's actually a bit interesting because he normally, when you're leading the race, you would not make the 10 point because you would consider.
But
just
it's not so much.
Exactly.
That's
my point.
Yeah.
Exactly. Normally, you would just play to the 7 if you're leading the race by a lot.
Yeah.
Like this. But here, the thing is, you are only 13 pips ahead, and if you make the 10 point, it's pretty good holding point and a good landing point as well. You can you can bring the checkers down from the midpoint.
You mean you stop my double sixes?
And you stop and exactly. That's a key point. That's your big comeback in the race is a double six, and the double sixes are blocked now by the.
And you make an extra point like to clear the other ones.
You can land on this.
Yeah.
So it's a good play.
It's a good play. 6-3 here. I, you know, built my board.
Yeah, I mean, it looks normal.
Yeah.
Keep the midpoint again.
4-2. A bit awkward, but just playing down to the.
Yeah, again the same idea. If he was leading by some more, he could consider clearing the 10 point. But
yeah.
But
it's too early.
But the lead is not great enough.
I still have some timing.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. So and a 4-3, I just keep on building my board. I can consider make. Often that is correct. To if it gets really awkward, take one down from
break
the midpoint, and especially if you have a strong board, of
but
course.
Here you're not forced to
I'm not forced to.
And your race is fine, so you don't want to leave a shot.
I still get my chances with a 6-1, So and a 2-1 here. This is interesting because he plays to keep checkers in front, makes the 2 point and then plays from there, which I don't know why it's actually such an error in according to XD. Can you?
I think it's just a bit better to have the 3 point in general than the deeper 2 point.
Yeah. So it's a matter of because it's very close now the pips and you just also want to. Have a strong board. When I would be escaping.
It's probably both because of the stronger board and also a bit better for the race to have to not make a deep point.
Very
5-1.
Important also to consider 5-1 here. So actually, XG likes to go out here because of the board. Because maybe he played that.
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure he wouldn't have considered this if you would have made the other.
Yeah, maybe.
He likes to go out.
You have a lot stronger board.
Or it likes to go out, and I'm not finding that over the board.
It's
I play this one here, 13-7, which looks more natural to me. So
let's think about it for a while. I think it's also something to do with the race again. The race is
even
after the row.
Yeah.
So if you play out, you give yourself a chance to just run it home. If you run, roll something good next time.
Yeah.
And you have him outboarded by a five point board against a 2 point board.
Yeah.
So and the one you make is a bit dangerous in the race because if you get hit on the midpoint.
True.
Like a 1-5, you lose a lot in the race, and you can get stuck easily on the 21 point, not being able to move later, so you don't realize
you're
your racing moves.
Yeah, true. And he can hit more safely, so to say, with this one here than here. If he hits here, he often would, give more blots or something like that, But interesting, close. And he rolls a 4-3 where he has two options.
Again he can keep the priming point, but now it becomes really, really awkward.
Keeping
so
the prime point, it means that you really,
you really strip your
stripping
position.
And just
But still, it's pretty close. So it says something about how strong the 10 point is against the 21 anger in such a close race.
In a close race,
But still, he should play the more flexible.
He plays the more flexible,
which he did.
Yeah.
So you roll double.
But it's close.
Double fours.
I roll double fours.
So now the race is pretty good for you.
Yeah. And I play down there, which is
keep the 5 point board.
Yeah. 3-1 is you unstack from the sixes and you play to keep your more flexibility here. Just 2-1, which plays very good. 5-1, and now I really want to go out and compete now, and I'm leading the race, so I
definitely
I would really make a big blunder if I would have lifted from here.
Yeah.
So
he has two blots in the board,
so you're not
afraid.
So you want to go out now, you're leading the race and you're not afraid.
And he has two blots in the board,
so
you're not afraid to go out.
Exactly. And I played the natural, I would say, out and then giving a little bit more ammo to make the 1 point.
Yeah, but I guess it's not so important to diversify builders in the board. Maybe just there's a greater duplication of threes, so and it's better running play to when you're leading a race to go all the way.
So the
it's easier to escape. So I guess that's why it's a little better.
Yeah. This separates, you know, the
I don't know,
the
I'm
world champions,
no,
you know,
no,
and
I'm
the.
I might have played 3-2 as well, but
yeah.
I'm just trying to find the reason why it's better.
Sure, but actually, likes to go all the way.
Yeah, exactly.
5-1. So 6-3 here is, you know, you don't want to give any shots, and he can do that with one.
Yeah, that's just one
play. One move.
Yeah.
So
that's
he plays down there. String
the board.
String the board, 6-3, where I play, of course, with
actually
escaping the. Yeah.
Even though you're leading in the race now, you are that the contact is in your favor.
Mm-hmm.
So it makes sense to stay on the 21 point, especially since you're His board is not so strong.
This is just, you know, giving too many chances to him.
It's just it makes it easy for him, this one,
yeah.
Because he can just, if he rolls a high number, he could just...
And if I would have played the other one,
play
according
it.
To XD, I would have made the point out here. Most definitely.
Oh, ah, yeah.
Right?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
Probably.
Yeah,
probably. Yeah, you're thinking about the 5-1?
Yeah, the 5-1.
The roll before? Yeah.
But I play, you know...
Yeah, good play. Sweep.
And 6-4... is actually interesting because he can play now safe.
He can play safe.
13-7, 6-2. Where you play 13-7 and 6-2.
But
which are probably, I don't know, many people would do, I guess.
Yeah, I guess.
Being afraid of putting a man on the bar.
Yeah.
Against a strong board and you know. Yeah.
But
very often you want to kill my race chances and just, you know, getting a better chance of, you know, me fanning and just, you know, killing it.
When you can put the opponent on the bar against the 4-point board.
Yeah. A good rule.
it's often good to do. Even now he gets 11 hitting rolls, but he also gets 16 fanning rolls. So he's actually, it's more likely that he will fan that it will hit you.
Yes. And also, if he wouldn't be hitting, he would actually be trailing a little bit in the race, and I would very easily escape, and also I have the flying shots here.
Yeah, exactly. So there's a lot of little problems with or big problems with playing the seemingly safe 6-4 here.
Yeah.
So
and it's actually a huge
just attack
blunder not to do it, and he plays it well and correct.
Yeah.
Putting me on the bar,
and you fan.
And I fan, so it's a perfect scenario for Stefan.
Exactly.
And he doubles here, and this is very interesting, Thomas.
It's quite interesting. We talked a bit about it before. That's these positions with one checker on the bar against either 5-point or 4-point board, and the one checker is the all you need to do is run it home, then you will, you know, have a good chance of winning the game. These cubes are quite difficult to evaluate, and I actually have a rule of thumb in these kinds of positions that
from
an old Danish player called Mogens Knudsen,
who told
it to Lars Trabolt,
yeah.
Who told it to me.
Yeah.
That if you're on the bar against a 5-point board with the 4-point or 5-point open, with a single check on the bar, then in order for you to take, you need to be close to a favorite if you enter the first time. So if this was a 5-point
even race or
even
the race
or leading the race, if you enter, you should be able to.
Not
really
under attack, maybe like, you know, afterwards, right? Mm.
Yeah, you should be able to if you enter the first time, to have an even or better game, basically, you know, in order to take. If you're in a position where even if you enter the first time, you're still going to be an underdog, then it's a pass.
Yeah.
But if you have a position where if you enter the first time, you're going to have
on
a,
high, you
have
know,
an even game.
high point, so it's the 20 or the 21.
20 and the 21, yeah.
And that's it.
That's the
rule
of thumb. Or
the 19.
So it's basically a position like this. And we see this position, it's even better for the tech side, because even if with the 4 point closed, you would be kind of even money if you enter the first time. And here, there's also a chance that he won't close the 4 point.
Mm.
So,
comparing with a closed four-point board, it would be actually.
Let's imagine we took the checker from the ace and put it on the four. It would probably be close to a take even then.
Mm.
So here you have the added chance of him not making the 4 point, the 5 point board with the, let's say he rolls a 6-5 or something.
Yep.
Then you also have the shot. So comparing it to the reference position of the rule of thumb about entering the first time and being even money, then you are better off here, because you can either hit and be much better than even money, and you can also just roll a 5 and be even money.
So really well played by Stefan.
That's
not
also
my best game, but I will not make this error again. So I learned from this.
Also, of course, an added bonus to his right play with the 6-4 is that you have a really good cube, and your opponent might have a difficult decision if you.
Obviously, he would.
Obviously,
so well played, Stefan, and he's now leading 1-2-0. So 5-4 opening, and I get a 3-1, which is perfect for me. 3-6, he runs out with the front man, and not
minimizing
the shots and so on.
Also, normally you would split to the 18, but if we look at it here, the problem with this in this position is we get a lot of double hits. We can hit on the bar and the 3 point at the same time with a lot of rolls, and this is just a lot safer.
Yeah.
Also, when the opponent makes the 5 point, it's you just want to try to escape as quickly as possible.
Yeah.
So yeah. Next.
So 5-4, which is a
good roll. Again, we see that of course we hit with the 4, and some players might be tempted to hit on the ace, but
the
it's
overplay.
Too early. It's too early.
Yeah,
it's compared to putting a check on the 8, maybe put it up. It's just so positionally nice to have this distribution.
Yeah, there's so no reason to go all in. But he fans.
He fans, and now we're looking at a double. It's again, it's a case of many many good things, small good things in the position. You have the stronger board, you have the better race, you have the much better structure, you have the 5 point, and you're looking to make the 4 point or the bar point. And you have some attack.
Mm.
And the opponent hasn't made anything. He still has a 1 point board and some stacks.
Yeah.
So it's a really good double.
Mm.
And the take is not so easy, because you're behind in every department. But it's still a take, because you're not that far behind. You are only 9 pips behind. You're you're only against a 2 point board.
Yeah.
The opponent still has 2 checkers on the 24, so you have enough for a take.
Yeah.
A double take.
Unless he knew I would roll double four.
Double fours is of course a big joker.
It's a good roll, and a very good roll, and I make 2 points. And
and this is actually
it's not totally obvious, but I'm really attacking here.
It's actually quite interesting, because it's the making the 2 points in the board like you did the 4 point and 2 point is kind of the play you want to make when you already doubled. Because now you are just going for the gammon and for the closeout. But for example, if it was a DMP, or you had owned your cube or something, then you might
safe,
really consider making the 20 anchor. Or if it was a
often,
kind of
you know,
a gammon,
you make
safe
the 20 anchor with a double four, and
the 20 anchor is often really really strong.
Yeah.
But here you just have too strong an attack, so you're going for the gammon.
But putting two men on the bar, I mean, point shifting can often be correct, but here it just looks awkward.
Yeah, you need to give him a little bit too many rolls to come in with two.
Yeah. So I play this one here, and he enters with a one, and the six is I mean,
yeah,
obvious, but I don't mean, I mean, you know, it's just, you know,
yeah, you
for some maybe it's tempting to just, you know, minimize the hits, but you know,
you want
you
to
just
make
want
the most
to make something
also you duplicate
constructive.
You do duplicate some sixes,
yeah, so it's
by doing
it's,
it
it's, and of course never play out here because you know you would be really
yeah
under the gun,
you
and then it's
keep
just
the,
you know,
you need to keep the ace point game, that's the best you can.
This is no, just, you know, suicide of course. So and I get double ones. I really like to make
plays itself, yeah, really strong to make the prime
here and split, so this is a good roll also, and 6-4 here, which is interesting because he can start to
counter prime
doing that. He needs to give a shot in two ways without hitting and trying to build something here, or to hit, which is deep. But he plays the 6-4, putting me on the bar, and yeah, trying to, you know, and just crossing his fingers that, you know,
yeah,
something good will happen,
yeah,
and he gets and that he gets a two, you know.
It's a human play, I would say.
Yeah.
To make the deuce,
so,
and also the right play.
And also the right play. So, good
6-5. Hit.
And I get a 6-5 where I'm hitting, and he fans. I get a double two, which is a good roll because now I can strengthen my board even
yeah
more.
Most important.
Yeah, so 1-4 he enters and he just, you know, plays from the 8, natural. 6-5 here is interesting.
Uh-huh.
I can escape from behind and play to 13, which I played, duplicating the 2s and just, you know, yeah, running home with them. I can also stay there and maybe, you know, fishing for more gammons, perhaps, I guess, and
yeah, I think what you played is the right way to win the game.
Uh-huh, yeah.
Because you just want to bring your checkers home and win the game.
In DMP,
but it's
a great move. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, especially in DMP, yeah.
So actually, it likes
but
to go down here and stay home and just, you know, trying to build.
But
his sixes are, yeah, dangerous also.
But, you know, in a position where gammons do count, and in the or at a score where gammons count, and when he has a bit of an awkward position with the deep deuce point and the blood and the board, you could go for the slot of the six prime, because if you're able to contain his three checkers on the 24 point, you're gonna win a lot of gammons. You're gonna be favorite to win a gammon,
yeah,
or close to favorite.
If I'm doing this, and he rolls a six, you know,
yeah,
is it only like 6-2 that he hits and makes, or where does he hit where he doesn't cover the blood, you know, on his?
He should definitely,
yeah,
but
which also opens up the gammon.
But you get some extra chances.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, you can hit the blood and.
Yeah.
And if he doesn't roll a six, you can make it. So it's
you know, big swing in the gammons from 30 from where I which I played wins a little bit more, but only wins 27% gammon.
Yeah,
and
now
he wins actually almost 37. So it's almost a 10% swing here.
It's
in gammons.
It's actually from his point of view, if you play what you played, it's kind of like a small relief. Because now he's not under pressure to he can play a lot of pips behind you. He can play down from the midpoint. He can make the he has some time to roll a six and escape one of the three checkers.
Yeah, I'm not a favorite
so,
to make
so
the
it's a kind of a relief when it comes to saving the gammon for him.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, it's it also makes it more hard for him to win the game. But at least the worst is over.
Yeah.
If you had slotted the seven, he would just be under pressure.
Very true.
To roll a six.
Interesting. So, and he rolls a 4-1, or he just starting to build his board.
Sure.
And I roll an awkward double one here.
That's pretty bad.
So it's, you know, by far the worst role, which is also anti-joker, so I have to lift my home.
That would have played better if you had slotted.
It would, also a reason to have done it, but I play something like this.
Yeah,
whatever.
You need to break the board and leave no shots. Yeah.
So and he gets a 5-1. So yeah, and he takes he uses the opportunity now to out and fish a little bit to
exactly
the point and makes the bar and makes the point and makes
it's really good.
Yeah, he makes
it's
his
really
board.
Good. He now he also gets what you would call a pseudo anger on the 19.
Yeah,
and he makes a stronger board, so it's really good for him.
So it's really good, and equal strength in the boards actually. So 6-2 now.
Two.
I really just want to get take us home and just
for big doubles.
Big doubles or exactly, and he gets a 4-3. Which place from
built
20-6, and I get my doubles, small ones,
super,
but a good roll.
Super good roll.
So why not make the 9 point here?
The problem with making the 9 point is now you have 2 points to clear, so it's much more difficult for you. If you make the 11 point with four checkers, you have some two spares on 11 point. You can attack him on the 19, and if he makes the 19 point, you can attack him on the ace. So it's both easier to clear and easier to attack
also easier to attack. So
clearly better.
Clearly better. And I played all four downs and double twos. He just he makes the 9 point, which is also
fine.
And
just make the
make
some
good points. If there would be some exchange of hitting, it's strong to have the 9, having the open 3 here.
Just try to make
but something,
points.
Building something.
Yeah.
And 4-3, I just, jump in.
Yeah, just clear.
3-2, he cannot, and probably he wouldn't have done that, from the 19, but he just, makes something.
Ah, look at the first play. That's really
it's an XG move.
An XG move. It's kind of clever. You have three checkers, three builders for the 5 point.
Yeah.
Also this way, but probably a little easier to make. Okay.
And I get a 4-1.
4-1's pretty.
So I of course have to hit.
Obvious. Yeah, you have to hit and just cross your fingers.
Yeah.
Hope you don't get.
And he rolls one of his jokers from the bar. 1-5.
Super good,
and I'm really now, of course, wishing for a 3 because then there's a lot of gammon in here, having a lot of plots.
Exactly.
But
backgammon's even. You fan and looking at a difficult cube.
And now he doubles or redoubles.
Actually, you have to think about this for a while because you still have some chances because he's behind the prime and it's not every roll that closes like almost every roll. 2-1, but it's still.
If I enter, I get many awkwards.
The problem is also here that
1-5, 1-4, which actually leaves
you can also get gammon here. You can get
gammon here. 3-3. He can
fish for more checkers after he
very
makes
easily get like 2 or 3
point.
On the bar. Yeah. So. Yeah. So now I'm behind. 3-0 against one of the best Icelandic players, and he gets a 6-4, and he runs. Probably he thinks leading. He runs, but it's those three options are often very close.
Yeah.
So
I think I would run as well.
Yeah.
Leading 3-0.
5-2 is a good roll.
Again,
don't double hit here.
Again, we see that it's much better to
be more
strengthen the 8 point than hitting on the ace. It's just too expensive to get hit back and bad to have a check on the ace.
Yeah,
too early.
6-2. Actually, it's interesting here because sometimes when I have like a strong 8 point here and. What's the rule here of when you actually can play this?
It's actually,
I think it's good when you have when you duplicate sixes and
mm-hmm.
and you cannot do that.
Yeah, I cannot do that here
because
there's
a lot of
6-1,
6-3, 6-4. So yeah, it makes sense kind of, but it's also a role. It's also a move to slot to seven is it's more attractive when you are behind in the match.
Uh-huh, yeah.
Because
okay.
You want to
probably would have been if it would have been other way around.
Yeah,
score wise.
Probably would have been correct. So.
Yep.
So he makes the right move.
Makes the right move. 4-1. It's a great roll because I put him
you
on
make
a bar.
Make the bar. Yeah.
And 5-1 here is interesting because, you know, often when you enter and you have a 1 and you have like similar boards, you often slot the 5, you know, on your home board, which it does,
yeah.
You know. But I...
The problem with slotting the 5, I think, is it doesn't really duplicate anything. You now you have 1s, 2s, and 3s to hit on the golden point, and you have 4s to hit on the his golden point.
Mm-hmm.
So so you have a lot of rolls that play constructively, and he has 3 bloods.
Yeah.
And you have a lot of checkers to attack with.
Yeah.
So and another thing. The checker on the 23 is a bit primed, so it would be good to improve its position playing it to the 22.
Mm-hmm.
So
even though
he's a little bit behind in the race, it's better to try to escape the two checkers.
Even though he's
a little bit behind in the race,
is it a score thing also? Do you think?
Probably also the score makes a little difference, but mostly I think it's just too big to slot when it's actually also like a rule of thumb that you shouldn't split and slot at the same time.
Oh,
it's,
okay.
It's often better to slot when you have an anchor, like
yeah.
The 24.
That's very that's you know a really good rule of thumb, and the safe play is and actually the second best is also just playing to 8, but getting a bit behind the prime, so he wants to move up.
Yeah,
get a high anchor, or you know,
it's good to
escaping.
Be good to be in the 22 point because even though you get attacked here by on the 20 point, you can still make the 22 anchor,
yeah.
Which points are over the prime.
Yeah,
so
duplicate the threes.
Yeah.
Duplicate the threes, but I get two of them. So no, if he would have played the other one, it would have been even worse for him.
That's true.
But
he feels good about his play.
He feels good about his play. Although I rolled a really big joker here, I. Yeah.
Again, it's you make the more aggressive play, which is correct.
Really,
you could also consider making the 21, but it's you don't
oh
really
yeah,
need it.
The
yeah, find it. It's way
find
down
it somewhere. It's the passive aggressive play.
Yeah,
which is not really
you don't really need an anger.
No,
you're not under attack yourself.
No.
You have a strong attack, so
it's better.
Distribute
it better and get more chance of hitting. But making 2 points is often the correct thing in double threes here.
Again, you give him 9 fanning rolls instead of just 4.
Yeah, if
so.
He fans, is it too good then? But we don't need to discuss that now, maybe. But he makes
probably too good, yeah.
Yeah, I think so. Too. But the double two is a really good. No, yeah, it's a really good entry number, and he
plays it right.
He plays it correct, but you know, the thing is, you could play, you know, something like making the 4 and getting ready to make the 5 and staying behind, but. But
he is a bit primed on the 23. You can make the 8 and he will be primed, so it's pretty good to get the 21.
It's really good to get the 21.
Also, when he's leading the match, it's also better to have a high anchor.
So, playing
he played it well.
Played well.
And it's also good to the formation with the slot on the 5 and the builder on 11 is really strong because now we can make it with 6s next time.
Yeah.
If you don't roll 4.
Yeah. 6-4.
Super good roll.
Super good roll. Hit 2, of course. He enters with 2. And now, you know, I'm actually 53 pips ahead. He doesn't have anything here. I have some attack. Although he enters with 2, I was, in the match, I remember thinking I was too good.
Ah, yeah.
So I played on too good.
And
when I see it now, I would probably have doubled. But but in the match,
I think even if you think you're too good here,
mm-hmm.
then I think you should double, because he doesn't have a man on the bar, and he has a high anger. So
yeah.
Even if for some reason you were too good, some people might still take it.
Uh-huh.
And
of course. Giving him the opportunity to
and in order to play on too good, it's often a lot stronger when your opponent is on the bar. So yeah, I think you could even get some takes here. So also in a practical game, I think it's a good double, even if it was slightly too good. Now we see it's slightly not too good.
Yeah, it's
even
very
though
close.
It's a big pass, but I think you could get someone to take this.
Yeah. Anyway, I roll, and I roll 6-5. Where
of course, there's also the advantage of rolling that you might get him to lure him into a take later on or something.
Yeah.
Like a wrong take.
Yeah. 6-5. It's interesting because I can just play safe and just make a prime.
I can understand. I can understand why you
but
make
I'm
the
just,
blitz.
I don't know. I just want to.
I can understand why you make the blitz, because you have you just played on too good and you want.
I want to justify it.
Yeah, exactly, you want to justify it, and also.
He's killing him.
Yeah, and you think, okay, I can cash later if it comes out, but the problem is you're a little bit disconnected. You have a. You have a checker back on the 24, and you have three bloods, and you make you kill the good prime, the good bar point.
Gives him some jokers, and
you instead just make this, then have a strong prime.
Yeah.
His anger is
he's
fairly well primed.
Has some
and
really
this
awkward rolls
where
it gets where it gets some shots, and
this checker down here is also just really really in a bad position when you make this.
If I would have played this. His twos, he would have to lift because he's really under the gun, right? All right.
I guess so.
Yeah.
And also, when you play this, you're almost guaranteed to win the game with the cube in the middle, because how can he even get a take? Like a double twos is not even a take, I guess.
I'm playing the aggressive move, which wins more gammons, and loses less. But anyway, I played it. So and he fans. And
now
I'm
you're
thinking,
clearly too good.
Now I'm clearly too good. So I roll on. 4-3, which
makes a seven. Yeah.
And he keeps on fanning, and I'm just then.
What about doubling?
Sorry, he doesn't fan. I'm sorry. He gets a 4-3.
Yeah. Exactly.
So he plays, of course.
And you still play on too good here.
This.
I think this is also a good practical double, because even though it might be slightly too good. It's not so unlikely that someone might take it, because
it's just borderline.
From his perspective, he might see some gold at the end of the rainbow.
Yeah.
To see that he can make the bar point, he can make the 5 point, and get a game, even though it's a big pass. So I think in practice you might get some takes here.
I didn't have it on auto roll or something like that. but I played on and I
escaped
with my checker and
you don't win so many gammons when he has
true
when
he has
20
on
one anger, even though he has four checkers on there. So
he gets
he
a 4-2 and he
makes
something and I'm winning here.
You're still
28% gammon or something like that.
Okay, now you're slightly too good again.
Slightly too good.
It's
but
also now
practical or double, I guess.
But now I think it's also like a free roll on the gammon, because you have no really bad rolls.
No.
Not
even 6-3 or double one or double. Yeah. No.
No, you don't really have any bad rolls, so you can always cash next
free roll,
next time. And I can see that you did. He rolls 6-2.
I get a 6-2, so I
normal play.
He gets a double six.
Yeah, and that puts him in the race. No, that puts him in now that. That makes an outfield point that you have to
makes the outfield point, and he strengthened his board, takes, now I double. And yeah, so I mean, my strategy perhaps worked.
Yeah,
I lured him into a take.
You lured him into a take.
Yeah,
it's I can see why he took, because now he wins a lot of games. He has this outfield point. Problem is, his board is still pretty weak, and he can still, if a hitting contest starts before he makes another point, he can still lose a lot of gammons. Let's say you roll like a 6-1, you clear one, and then you roll. Then you roll a 6-5, and you clear the midpoint next roll, and he has to hit from the from his 20 anchor, break that without having made the board yet.
Yeah.
Then you can re-hit and win a gammon. So it's he's a bit underdeveloped to
leading the match
to take
a bit. So yeah,
also
but
leading the match.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So but he took and I rolled a 2-1 where. It's a bit cunning here. The bot, it actually placed down to 11.
That's also
wow.
that shows you
making like you know a little bit unflexible distribution here, but
yeah,
it just wants to clear now and take the chance now.
It's also it shows you why it's probably not a take the role before when you can mess with him like this, like play to the 11.
Yeah.
It's really awkward for him to hit with the aces because he will have to break his defensive outfield point.
And I make a mistake here, making 6-3, which I don't know.
Can I look? Because when you make this, it's also you give yourself a really really good 6-2, for example. You can clear this and the 5-2 you can clear maybe even the 4-2.
Yeah.
And when you make this, you don't clear any with any rolls.
Mm.
So it's basically
it's advanced, you know, but it's
advanced pay now because he's underdeveloped, but it's really difficult to find.
3-2 slots.
Yeah.
Start to
he just wants
to
make
his board. A 5-3 would have played, I guess, you know, making the 8 if I would have played the other one.
Yeah, maybe. A double shot. Yeah, that was would have been an option.
I don't have any options here. Just playing to the 5. Now he rolls a double 1. What's happening here? So this is interesting. He decides to actually move this, you know, anchor, and making it easier for me to get home.
It's the double aces is a bit awkward for him
because he has one
ace too many.
He has one ace too many.
Yeah. So if he just could play 3 aces, he could make the 5-point and shift to the 3-point.
Yeah, yeah.
But now, or to the 14. But now he has to move a fourth ace.
Yeah.
Which is pretty bad. So.
I'm sorry, but he makes actually.
He makes this.
we're wrong here. So he actually does, you know, what we're thinking of now, which is correct. So he keeps the 15 point here, but according to XT here is, you know, not destroying your board so much maybe. It's actually correct. I don't know.
Let me look at
the reason.
It's a bad roll double aces because he has one ace too many, and the problem is he really wants to build a strong board. If he plays this as he does, that he has kind of like a failed blitz position with the ace point and the 3-point and the hole in the deuce and still not a 4-point board.
Mm-hmm.
So it's very very difficult to get a good prime good board here.
Yeah. So actually, it's not even if you play like 6-5, 6-3, it's not a error really. It's a minor error.
This
so
gives
a
greater chance of remaking a strong.
Yeah, I would probably
5-point.
Have looked at this one.
So he has many options. This is also a little bit better.
Yeah.
But this is basically any play that gives you a chance of remaking a strong board pretty quickly.
Yeah. Yeah.
And his play is a bit too. It becomes a bit too much of a failed blitz position with the ace.
Yeah.
The ace is really really bad to make.
Uh-huh.
So that's it. And you roll a 4-3, and actually now you, yeah,
now you have a really good pay now option, which you make use of.
Very ugly to just play, you know, safe.
Yeah, this would be a big mistake.
I don't know if you use that term in English, you know, pissing in the pants, you know, just, you know, doing this, you know.
To keep warm.
To keep warm.
But postponing the problem.
Postponing the problem.
Yeah, this would be safe, but it would be really, really bad. What would happen was that he would make...
Not in the long run. Yeah.
He would make the 5 point pretty quickly, and then you would be in a much worse position unless you roll one of the very few doubles.
Yeah.
So making this now is also good because you duplicate his aces to make the 5 point.
Yeah, so it's clear.
So, it's very clear.
So, and I'm... Yeah, so he gets 3-6... So he hits.
He hits, and he,
which is correct, and
he makes the play that the most ambitious play.
Yeah, the gutsy ambitious play.
He makes the ambitious play and goes for another builder. But the problem is, he also creates some more blots.
Yeah,
he could play with just two blots and less shots.
Yeah,
which is we also see a little bit the problem with his tech here.
He wins more, but loses more gammons.
Exactly.
With his
the problem with his take up here was that when he gets the shot, as he did down here, he's not developed enough, and he will suffer a lot of, you know, gammon risk, and that's exactly what happens here.
All right.
So he makes an ambitious play, and you
and I get the super joker punish.
You get the super joker,
5-4, puts two men on the bar.
Double hitting,
and
two, one.
Yeah,
4-1, brings it home.
Yeah.
5-4.
Gets out.
Now he's in
just,
in
know,
a
he's serious a problems
favorite
now.
To win, to lose a gammon.
Favorite to lose a gammon.
And this comes out, clear. Okay, now he plays a little... He goes for the gammon save.
Mm.
He's often close these plays.
Yeah.
Take off. Yeah, and you—it's good to try to clear the 6 point quickly.
Yeah.
That will take care of the problem before he's too strong here.
Yeah. It's close.
So.
But
6-4.
So I'm doing there. 2 off. And now 3-2. Let me see here.
I'm going
for the gammon.
You're
going
for the gammon.
So
it's a really good play.
Hmm?
You win 100% games if you clear the but you lose. You give up like more than 10% gammons.
Yeah.
These positions are often very interesting, and you have to count the gammon race. And often, if it's just a little bit close, you should play aggressively for the gammon. And that's, I know this used to be my most common mistake in these types of positions, that yet you really don't want to get hit and lose the game. So you play the
safe ghosts.
Play. You see ghosts, and you, but you really, really don't want to lose or not win the gammon either. So really good play, just taking 2 off.
6-5.
He stays here, of course.
Stays there, of course.
And now you're forced to
take.
Go for
now
the
he's also forced to get out. Take you off.
Really bad roll.
2-1 is a really bad roll because now I can. Have a bigger chance.
So now you have. You just need to roll 5-3 or better.
And I get a 5-4.
And you get a 5-4.
So mission complete.
So you're leading the match. This one.
4-3. All right. So I open with 4-2, and he gets a really good
double force.
Joker actually, double force,
making the now it's really, really attractive to make the
even more attractive.
20 anger.
6-5 here is actually interesting. So
it
doesn't want to run, which is more often the right the natural play. But
this is actually an interesting.
I have a better board and. Strip from the 8 here, and I just want to maybe lure him something. But it's
the race is a little bit worse for you.
Third roll,
And actually also making a
huge mountain, yeah, as Michi would call it, on the midpoint is a bit awkward.
Mm-hmm.
So and leaving this checker down here is a bit awkward. So so it's
if you can find this, you really
studied
one of the best in the world. If you study it. So double force. He keeps on rolling double force. So he just, you know, runs out and makes 5 points. It's good. Making two in the board is also good. It's very, it's actually totally even according to XG. But he runs out. And now I just run, you know, with a 6-5. So so we get a race here, more or less. And he's actually leading the race here with 4 pips. 5-1, plays down. Fair enough.
Yeah, it's very simple position.
6-3, I just play something like, you know, this. Double ones. He, he's leading the race and just wants to get closer.
He's leading a little bit.
A little bit.
Like
so
one pip. So,
so he could play this.
Yeah.
He could, you know, these are
even.
Totally even.
It's
dead
not
even.
So
dead even.
Interesting.
Not so interesting. 6-5, 4-3, 4-2, 5-4, and he's leading.
Clear.
Just clears
5-2, 5-2,
6-5.
Very
five.
Even game.
Very even.
Very even still.
Five
will,
three,
will it be one
until
of those games where it doesn't get?
Yeah. And it gets a high.
So we need a good.
We get a double
6-2.
And I got a 6-2, and clearly a double with 12 leading,
yeah,
12 pips, and
yeah. Normally you can, you need to be less than 10% behind in the race. And here you're more than that.
Yeah.
So
a big pass.
It's a big pass.
Right.
Two crossovers also.
4-1.
4-1.
Yeah. Standard. 6-2 hits. Very good roll. 5-2. Interesting. I move up my checkers like this instead of going up to the 18. It's close.
Pretty close, yeah.
He rolls a double 5 here, and a double 5 in the opening, you know, you're very often just, you know, blitzing, making, you know, the 3 and making the 1. Here he doesn't put a man on the bar with making the 3 here. He does with making the 1, and he's escaping, you know, with 1 here. So actually the right, the correct move is, you know, put a man on the bar and, you know, cleaning up this. So
now he's also, he's 33 pips,
mm-hmm,
ahead, and he just has one checker, one backman left to escape. So he really doesn't want to get hit.
But he plays this.
Exactly, and that's the problem with that is, mm-hmm, he leaves 3 bluffs and a lot of shots.
Yeah, and I'm likely to get a high anchor, and then, you know, his points in the bar board is not useless, but not as valuable. So his distribution
it's
is
not
just, you know,
it's not so attractive to also break the 8 point and
mm-hmm,
leave a blot.
Yeah.
And
even giving a double shot or more shots because
a lot more,
yeah,
shots. This is 0 shots and just a really, really nice position to bring home.
Yeah.
So
but
it's very
the
very
other
risky.
One, the other candidates are the top 3 candidates are making the 1 point here, and that's all often right.
And keeping the 8.
And just keeping the 8 perhaps, or just something. And anyway, 6-5, and I get in, and I'm pretty happy with the position here. I get the anchor
and I stay back and I actually slot
here, so that's correct.
Yeah.
Instead of giving the shots and so on. So and he rolls a 6-5 where he
6-4, yeah.
6-4, I'm sorry, yeah, where he double hits, of course. And I double fan here. So he doubles. And actually, wow, it's not so far from a take. Which is
says something about the the strength of the 20 anchor.
Yeah.
That it's so close to a take.
But it doubles and I pass and it's
mm.
correct. So
mm.
yeah, well played. 6 behind 5-4 now. So 5-2. Slot. 6-3. Yeah, so if it would have been 6-4 it would have been a strength because then you would have probably hit. But it's a 6-3 and you run all the way
six
here because
it's,
you know,
interesting,
I have like
yeah.
the I have
it's an interesting opening reply that you run all the way here. Normally you would split with a
yeah.
like play this.
Yeah.
With a 6-3. But the problem here is first of all, you have both sevens and nines to hit here. That's a lot of shots. It's almost a direct
mm.
shot. Plus, you are under more attack here
yeah.
with four checkers here than three normally.
When there are like four checkers on the eight, and I get like 6-2, 6-3, I, you know,
you
run
there,
away,
and
that's
run all
mostly
way, so
correct.
It's the right
yeah.
play.
So he runs all the way. I get a 5-3, where I decide not to put two men on the bar, which is actually correct according
yeah.
to XG.
It's
but now I'm stripping, you know, my.
We had this theme
midpoint.
in
yeah.
many of the previous games
yeah,
where,
so
you
now
shouldn't,
it's the opposite.
Where you shouldn't, and because often you just it's just too deep with the checker down here, and
mm.
you don't want to get hit. But here the alternative starts to get
mm.
a little. You make
two towers,
yeah. two really really tall towers, and you strip the midpoint. So this is positionally, it's like a. You know, it's a nasty dilemma because you give up something in either case. Here you don't want to put a checker down here, but it's even worse to strip
and
the midpoint
and
make two towers.
Because making the 3-point with the 5-3,
yeah, it's too
it's
passive.
Too passive. Yeah.
And also, when you hit, you still. Do have
it's
you have a like 10 checkers in the zone? You have a okay
yeah.
distribution.
We don't
and
want
and
to get hit. I'm you know leading the race with 17 pips here.
Yeah,
but
that's
but it's
so it would be an even game if
it's
he
it's a hard decision.
Yeah.
Anyway,
so
you
rolled
a 3-1. So this is actually very very interesting because
that's very
yeah.
thematic. I
mm.
would say because
yeah.
when you have these two towers here, it's often the wrong idea to split,
mm-hmm.
and. Yeah, he's not in danger of you know getting primed. If you had like the 5-point, it would be much better to split because
mm-hmm.
of avoiding to get primed.
Yeah.
But here you don't want to get attacked,
yeah.
so you stay on the 24 and you
mm-hmm.
can make a pretty good hit here. Unstack the 6-point.
And taking the initiative.
Taking the initiative
mm-hmm.
and
mm-hmm.
taking away some good rolls for
yeah.
you, like some of those rolls that make these points. So what he plays here is a little bit too risky actually, because now your stacks, your towers, they come to life.
Yeah.
You attack with a lot of rolls, like
mm.
like a 5-1, you just double hit.
Yeah, he's also behind in the race and yeah. So plays this. Roll a 3-2, which is kind of.
Ah, yeah. You continue the stacking a little bit. Again, as his last one, it's not so bad to hit on the 3.
No.
So you can you could.
I think I took a long time, you know, thinking of this, and I don't know. It's just.
This
yeah,
is
I
yeah.
I
can.
I don't know.
Oh, you made this. Ah, okay. So you don't make an anger.
I don't make an anger.
I can see the idea here because you are leading 17 pips. You don't want to get hit. You just want
yeah,
to get them home, and he doesn't have really any
yeah.
attack.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
But yeah, it's
positionally yeah.
positionally
yeah.
pretty
yeah.
pretty good to
yeah.
make the anger
yeah.
not stack.
And
the
even this yeah the second
but
best candidate is just
it's
you know
not
yeah,
so
yeah,
huge.
Yeah, making this and getting shot there. But it's yeah slows. So
6-5.
And he runs out to 16 and put down to
8.
Yeah, that's looks fine.
Also improves his distribution.
Yeah. And then double six. Really
oh,
good
super good. Plays itself, hits here, and you get to unstack one of the towers.
Even the
worst tower, it's perfect roll.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you are ready to cube almost.
Double four,
regardless.
Double sixes. And he enters with.
He enters
with
two.
Yeah.
So now you're clearly not too good.
Yeah.
Because. Yeah, there's a lot of play in it
yeah.
from him, but now if this is a position you could make the mistake of taking in his shoes,
mm-hmm.
because when you just look at it, okay, I'm not on the bar, he only has a 2-point board,
yeah.
I can easily get an anger,
yes.
But then when you look at it more closely, you see that you are 34 behind, mm-hmm. and the other guy has like 12 checkers in the zone. He only needs to escape one. Lots of attack, just mm-hmm. too much
yeah.
pass. So now
game
the
seven.
Score is 5-5.
Even score.
Like an 8-point match. He starts with the.
Right, 3-1, 5-1.
5-1, split.
4-5.
5-4. Yeah, plays a standard.
Yeah.
He's not. Now when you have the two towers here, he's not so afraid when he has the 5-point
no.
because they protect him.
Yeah.
So 6-5.
Good roll.
Make
the 18 point.
5-5. Yeah.
Escape one guy.
Yeah, he's leading
guy.
The race now,
yeah.
so just run.
Yeah.
3-2. Yeah, you can afford to take a little chance
yeah.
by leaving the builders because you have the like the pseudo anger on
yeah.
the 18.
So 2 down, 13, and then
2 down,
3-1. He's leading the race, so he actually
interesting.
And he has a stronger board.
Interesting.
So he could consider moving up to
yeah.
the 21.
It's actually correct.
Which is correct. It's I understand the reasons why he doesn't do it because he feels like being threatened by
he feels that
but
he's a bit under attack
yeah.
if he comes
yeah.
up here, but the thing is that he's actually also in danger by staying
more
behind.
Danger of priming being
yeah,
getting
he's
primed
his real the real risk for him is getting stuck down there and getting primed
yeah.
So whether you make the 4-point in his head if he goes up or whether you just make it when he stays down, it's not a huge difference. It's still pretty bad just to get primed.
Yeah.
So if he comes up here,
mm-hmm.
he has a good chance if you're not able to point on him, he has a good chance of just escaping the next row. And he has the stronger board, so he can survive
yeah.
a hitting contest. So
yeah. He stays back playing 8-4. I roll a 6-3 where I start developing my board here, of course, and he rolls a 6-1.
That's also now. There's
mm-hmm.
also a bit of the problem. Let's say he had with the
yeah, it wouldn't have been a great number.
Yeah, exactly. If he had come up here and you rolled a 6-3,
yeah.
you would he would now get a direct shot on
yeah.
on this plot.
Yeah.
So now he's stuck down here. But now he
yeah.
plays. Now he sees the chance.
Very well
played
by Stefan because
yeah.
he's playing out now.
Yeah. He
really sees the danger of getting primed.
Yeah,
and,
the priming danger is just
makes
too
a better board.
And it's not so bad to get hit out here. He gets a lot of whether he's on the 24 or on the bar. It's not a huge difference.
Uh-huh.
And he really doesn't want to bury a checker on the deuce here and just stay passively.
Yeah.
Here he has. Some good things can happen. You're not guaranteed to point on him. On
mm-hmm.
him. There's
mm-hmm.
even some rolls that that miss,
course, yeah.
and he gets some return shots, and he keeps a good board.
Yeah.
So good play.
Good play.
5-4.
5-4.
So that's
yeah.
one of the
the 5-4.
Yeah.
So that's really a reason to get out there.
It's a big game. It's a really big game.
Big game changer. Yeah.
Yeah.
So I play something like
so close.
Yeah.
I just want to make a better point, but
yeah.
I can see also
yeah.
keeping a spare on the 8
mm.
is also some value.
Six
he was
four.
A good 6-4, so now he has
run
just has
first,
a good holding game.
And 3-1, just
build
developing
something. Yeah,
4-1.
He's ahead in the race, so
yeah.
he should just start clearing.
Mm.
He rolled double 6,
rolled
so
double
now
six.
Now
so
the race is
in my
shifting in your favor.
And making
and
something.
But now he's. It's actually a bit interesting that he went from being the one being held in the whole game to holding your 18
yeah.
points. So
yeah.
now it's the other way around. Now he rolls double 4. So now he's actually ahead again.
Yeah.
And just clears.
Yeah.
Only ahead by 7 pips.
Mm-hmm.
And now we get another even race.
Get an even race, which I'm going into, and
around 50%.
Yeah.
Still 6-4, 4-2, a bit bad roll, but black is not ahead enough to double.
No.
Still a blunder to double. 6-2, okay, roll. 2-1.
Really bad.
Bad roll, now it's back to even. Will we see a game without a cube? 4-2, two checkers off. Even race. Even race. 6-4.
Good roll.
Now white is a bit ahead. 4-1.
Yeah.
Bad roll. And now.
He actually.
Now you have a big lead. You have.
Same amount
three
of checkers
pips
off
in a short race.
And 3 pips in a short race, even,
yeah.
You know, match score.
Yeah.
I can see, you know,
yeah,
that it's being a double perhaps, but it's close, so, yeah.
Let's just check the race formulas.
Which we can't
yeah.
see. It says, like, you know, if
no,
you put
see,
if,
okay.
if you click the race formulas, it does say that, you know, can you explain?
If you, yeah, you have different race formulas.
Uh-huh.
The one I normally use is the Keith count. I won't explain it in details, but it says it would, if you use that here, it would say it's a redouble and a take, so
right.
you would think it was a big double.
Oh.
But there must be some things in the position that Keith underestimates.
Yeah.
Let's
move on, and I roll a 3-1, which is bad, or not so good. 4-2.
No, he rolls a double 5. That's a huge roll.
That's a huge roll.
6-5,
you know,
you
roll a 6-5, so
come
actually
back.
Come back a bit, so he has a huge double.
He has a huge, huge redouble. No?
Double.
Oh, you didn't double before?
No, I didn't.
Ah, okay,
yeah.
Oh, so I was wrong. I couldn't
yeah.
understand why
no.
why it was a mistake to double, because
yeah.
Keith said it was a...
Yeah.
It's yeah.
Yeah. So, and I'm happy that I didn't. Double before perhaps, but he does double, and it was a really good number, 6-5. Get a 6-2, yeah, 4-3, and I have to
yeah.
get a high roll. So, all right. Game 8, he's leading 7-5.
Okay.
4-3.
Yeah, he's...
Yeah.
He's plays it the standard
yeah.
way.
Yeah. 3-3, standard of course, 6-6, what's happening here?
Yeah, that's basically only...
Makes, just, you know, out and behind, yeah. Just, you
yeah, clear the blood. 6-5-4?
I'm sorry, 5-4, yeah.
It's a bit awkward roll.
Bit awkward, yeah. Yeah. Have to hit, of course, gets a 4 and a bit awkward 6, but he has to play it down to 7.
Yeah, that's much better than
yeah.
playing to the deuce.
Of course. And 5-2, I'm forced off, of course, here to hit. 3-2, he can't hit there, but he makes the
3 points, strengthening
three
his board.
Strengthening his board.
Makes
and
sense.
Way too big to just hit, you know, and
yeah, yeah,
too with many blocks.
With
the
blocks,
yeah.
yeah.
And also leading with 26 or more, 31
yeah.
something pips,
exactly.
you know. I get a 6-4, which is good because
it's
hit and
both hit and cover.
And not making the 2 point, it's better to have that, you know.
Clearly.
So this one here, so 5-4.
Yeah, his plan is just to run,
he,
run home.
Yeah, and he doesn't have anything else almost, you know. Yeah, so he runs out. I get a 4-1. Yeah, hit 2, actually.
Oh, that's good.
But it's interesting. And which 2, you know, should I hit? This is interesting because I can.
Yeah, you
I can play actually. So I play this one.
You
here.
Basically.
I hit
the
this
four
and into the.
I would say that the way I would approach it would be to say that the 4 is pretty clear because you need to hit 2 checkers.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
When he has.
So the 4 is clear. So.
Yeah. And then you have an ace, and you don't want to
yeah.
your 9 point has some or your 10 point has some value,
mm.
and you
it's
play with a
blocks,
lot of
you know.
Lot of blots.
Yeah.
Yeah, you play with here. You play with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 blots.
That's my thought.
That's
and
too
that's
much.
Why
that's
I
too much.
Think it's just too much.
And you can still pick up the his last blot here
yeah, exactly.
and play with a few
mm.
blots.
Right. So now he has to produce. Does he produce enough?
Four.
He gets just 1 checker in and. That's not enough.
And
I
this is actually this is quite devilish, I would say,
uh-huh.
because It looks like, at first glance, it looks like you have the blitz is not so dangerous. You're only a 2-point board. He has your opponent has some blots as well, and
but it's deadly.
but when you look at it a little bit closer,
yeah,
you see that 12 checkers in the zone, 3 blots, a lot of almost all rolls are really really constructive.
Yeah.
So it's just too much to survive.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's kind of a position where if you were trailing in the match, you could probably take it. If you're some trailing scores, because
you win like 32%.
You win a lot of games,
but you lose even more with
gammons.
Yeah. So he passes, and that's well played. And we're now into game 9, and I'm behind 6-7. And I roll a 6-4. I like to
make this,
you know, and especially when I'm behind.
Yeah.
And also just, you know, making, you know, this gives like, you know, the chance of the opponent making a mistake.
It's not so common for people to make it. So it's a lot of people don't know
what
know,
to do when you
yeah, it's
do you split or not.
Yeah,
or
yeah, should you how should you approach the game?
Yeah. So, but he rolls a double one and he
could
roll. I get a 5-2 roll here, 2-5. And he rolled 5-6, and of course he needs to play safe. Down
yeah,
to
seven also it's very nice to
very
to
nice to have this extra
to get a builder on the zone.
And I'll play 4-2, and
yeah, you're leading the race, so
just,
your plan
know,
is just to
escape.
Also escape his prime.
This is interesting because double ones here,
he should definitely hit. Somehow.
He needs to hit.
Yeah.
It's not a very good roll, but he plays it like, you know, from loose from the three.
I think I would have played as he did.
Yeah, I would have done exactly the same.
XG's move looks a little bit.
This is strange.
Strange.
We don't believe in
it.
XG3 will, you know,
yeah,
prove us wrong.
Be.
So 3-5 is a good roll. 1-6, not the best, but he now actually he has the options of going out and just, you know, fight for getting like, you know, the 18 point.
Also here it's also an issue not to have three checkers. The 24 point. It's really bad.
Yeah.
It's really bad. You want
so
to unstack that point.
Well played, Stefan. So, and I get a 6-5 here, and
you can play the.
And now it's, you know, it's a good play going out there because now, I mean,
yeah,
you know, my sixes are, you know, what should I do? Should I run and play safe? Which, you know, is an option. Or
I
run all the way, it's too big, but I do hit him and I get out. So
I think I would have played to 16 and 8, duplicating his falls over and just trying to run home.
The,
but
the wimpy play, but
yeah.
I'm Icelandic, so I hit. 3-1.
Close.
It's just.
Yeah,
you don't hit anything, and you just, you know.
And you want to get up to 24 points,
yeah,
so you.
So he plays
goes
it well.
Comes
so
to 21.
All right, so we get a
5-4.
5-4 here.
Ah.
This is where when I look at it now, I have to say that I think I would have made the 3, but but in the match, I don't know.
I can
spend a lot of time considering here, and so
I can understand your reasons for just wanting to you leaning the race by a lot.
So
just
ugly
wanted,
to
but
stand it here. And,
I think placing a third check on the deuce,
yeah,
is just your alarm clock. Your alarm bells should be going off. It's just it's
pissing in the pants again.
Yeah, but it's just there could be positions where it's right, but it's so ugly that you really really it should really really the alternative should be so risky for it not to be right.
Yeah.
So here it's okay. You're leaving some shots, but he still only has a 3 prime and
yeah.
And you make a good point yourself. You have a stronger board.
Yeah.
This is just quite difficult to bring home.
Yeah.
So
annoying rule though. But he gets a 2-1, so he gets his anger and puts one down. And I just, you know.
So now you don't even need the flexibility, you can just bring it.
I just, you know, I knew that I would rolled something great, which I did. Double fives, played yourself. 6-4, you don't run away with, you know, any with the, you know, you just play to strengthen your board. 4-1, safe, of course.
I was looking pretty good.
4-3.
But when should you cube?
Yeah, I mean,
it's
what,
yeah,
do
it's
we have a reference?
I would say in these kinds of decisions, wait until you have something that looks like a medium-sized market loser, and it's pretty difficult to lose the market. Also, a bit of the problem with the third check and the deuce. He has so much play for such a long time.
Yeah, yeah.
So
lots of timing.
Yeah, you're still far from a double.
Yeah. So, which I don't, of course. 3-2. I need to play.
You need to play
safe. And he makes a better board here.
Still
so
far
now
from
it's
a double.
So I get a 6-1, which I can play safe.
Yeah.
In two ways.
That's actually.
So this is even, you know, stacking up again.
Yeah.
And I
it's
think it's too ugly.
Yeah, it's
and of course, this one doesn't make him.
It's
this
actually.
This is the.
But now the.
Ambitious play and.
Now the.
I did it.
The danger of getting hit is much greater because he has a stronger prime and stronger board.
But
so
it's
now the safe play is not so bad.
Pay later or.
But
pay
still this. I'm actually a bit surprised. It's not a bigger mistake to play this.
Uh-huh. You would have played the same.
I guess. I hope.
Anyway, so now he really needs a 1, but he gets a double 3. He makes the.
He should.
He
should keep some contact. That's
no,
actually.
No.
He
no,
shouldn't.
No.
Oh, he shouldn't.
No, he shouldn't.
Yeah.
But it's just.
That would be this.
Yeah. And now I can consider something maybe. Let's see. I still have a long way, or a way, you know.
You almost have no market losers in this position.
Yes, Thomas is looking at the dice distribution, and what you can see here is which rolls are. Market loser is 4.7%, but it's, anyway, so it's.
Yeah. You're basically your only market losers are
double twos
and double fours.
Yeah.
And that's not enough.
So I roll on, which is correct, and I roll a 5-2, just bringing it
to safety.
To safety. A 6-2 here is very interesting because do you roll one to, you know.
Again, it's pretty alarming to break your prime and make it.
Yeah.
So you should only do it if the alternative is really, really dangerous.
Yeah.
And
it's not so dangerous here.
And not so dangerous because you still the more important anger is the 24.
So if you run from the 20, you still have the anger behind you. You could get a shot later on, and you're racing, keeping the prime.
Not so much racing, but it's more about keeping
not racing.
The
not racing, of course, not no more timing, of course.
Yeah.
But yeah.
And you're it's not breaking the prime and
all right. Anyway, so running out there, so which it doesn't, which means that you know I should definitely
have
doubled
this position.
And this is.
And now you can double because his position is starting to get a little bit ugly, and
you're
still starting to have some market loss.
I think it's tough though. I mean, but
I think this is also could be okay not to double in practice because he might still. Takes some cubes, but also some people might even pass.
I saw his take early on. I don't know if that had any influence, like you know, on my play.
You don't have that many market losers against
some
good double fours and stuff.
So 5-4, I have to clear, of course, from the 7.
Yeah, leave no shots.
Yeah, and
rolls
he gets
2-1.
It's quite good at keeping you know timing and.
So now you're only 1 point away from. If you clear the 8 point, he can't take.
Mm-hmm.
So that's your favorite to lose the market now. 55% market loser.
55%.
And that's basically also all the ones where you leave a shot and he misses, and then it's a pass. So it's now or never.
But
it's a big take, of course.
But I don't double. I roll a bad roll, so I give a shot. was Stefan's day.
Yeah.
And he.
But this is also if he had missed his shot, he would probably be a pass.
Yeah.
So it's, it was.
And he hits and.
But you
XD,
gained
them. XD likes actually to run from. All the way out with both, even this. But this is not just keeping the controlling the outer field more. I mean, with this one here, I'm sorry, this one. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know what the reason is that it's so big. It's actually.
I'm a bit confused why it's a mistake to play what he did.
Anyway, so he played this one here.
Because I would assume that on all your fanning rows, he cashes anyway.
No, but I fan.
Oh, it's a tick.
And actually, it's a tick.
Ah, okay.
This is also, I find it very hard to find a take here, but maybe you understand.
It's
actually a huge, it's a blunder actually to pass it. So
it's an unusual position. You are 45 pips ahead, and you don't lose many gammons. You still win a little gammon.
Yeah, but I have an awkward position, like, you know. With
that's true, and it's I would assume it becomes closer to a pass on rollout. Because it's kind of a position that the bots they underestimate the containing side, because it's
right.
More difficult to run home.
Let's just say that.
But
I'm now trailing 8-6-13, so we're getting closer to the end, and he gets a 3-1. I get a 5-1. He rolls a really good number, 6. But he decides to blitz here. This is not the right game plan.
Especially not when leading.
Especially not when leading.
But just in general.
In general, you want to prime.
This is
just, you know, this is so
this
strong.
You're almost cashing next roll.
Cashing next roll here. I mean, yeah.
Yeah, as with the cube
wins
in the middle.
Of course, lots of.
Yeah,
gammon,
it's not very effective with the cube in the middle, and the 18 point is so much stronger than the deuce, and it's not like you're guaranteed to blitz.
Yeah,
this is just really really sound and strong.
Just gives me opportunities here to get in, and I do get in, and I am forced to play to 7, and he has a small double actually here, although he's
right.
I'm sorry. He does double, and it's a small note double.
Yeah, probably because of the score.
Probably because of the score.
But this also says a little bit about why he should play the 6 like this, because now it's you roll the normal roll, not even a great roll, and he can't even double. Had he had the 18 point, he would be in a very commanding position for a long time.
Yeah, but it was a small note. But he plays, gets 3-2. Which is actually really well,
he finds a good one.
Finds a really good one because his strength.
There's also
and this is also a bit like the other theme here that I'm getting now the opportunities here.
Exactly, it's very thematic what he plays. First of all, you're not so much in danger of getting primed against the two towers. So and you're more in danger of getting blitzed against 10 checkers, even though you have a stronger board.
Yeah.
But if you just play the priming play, you put these stacks in a bit of an awkward spot. They can't really attack anything.
And the 6s are duplicated.
The 6s are duplicated.
Yeah.
So
it's a really good play. Yeah, although it's close. But I get the 4-1, so just make it a normal. Then 4-1 here is interesting because actually, what he plays, let's see. What he plays?
He plays. Makes a small split and makes.
Wow. So he's actually not getting up and trying to escape the prime. He wants to make his prime, but gives me opportunities.
This
really
is a
here.
Bit illogical. This I would say because.
Yeah. You're making too many things on the.
You're leaving 4 bloods.
Yeah.
You just now after you made the. The bar point and have a build on a 9. You are actually in a bit of a risk of getting primed. So you want to get out here
so
and
going to the 20
and
is
there's no six,
and then you look at the one
duplication of sixes anymore, so you want to you also want to get rid of this blood.
You're
so
leading like with 23 pip pips and
yeah, exactly.
And
just
you know,
just
win,
play the
win the game.
The natural now you have them a bit up with sixes and
yeah.
And leading
yeah.
the race, and even if you get pointed on here, you still have some anchoring roles.
Yeah.
When you play this, it's like a kind of like a dream position for you. You can hit with the sixes,
yeah,
with the small rolls. You can still prime
on both sides. I can, you know, get good rolls.
And it's not so, it's not such a huge slot for him, because oftentimes you will, you will either hit or it's he has to break the midpoint to make it. And
all right.
Yeah.
So mistake there, and I get a 5-2, which.
Plays itself.
Plays itself, and
6-3.
So now it's actually interesting here, because he has options.
Again, he should respect your prime some more.
Yeah.
Just stepping up and making this, and also duplicating your aces.
And also, it's very strong to make this.
Instead he
bar,
makes
the
this.
Bar, I mean the bar point is
point,
good.
The bar point.
I understand what it does,
yeah.
And it could be often correct if he wouldn't have two checkers behind getting primed, you know.
It makes some
sense,
but
he's running out of timing. You know, I'm really like, you know.
And again, you both have, you know, huge sixes and some small rolls
yeah.
that make.
So
this
is
gives you a bit too much.
Bit overplayed here.
There's also this option, the safe one.
Yeah.
But again, it's pretty good to come up here to just to try to challenge.
Duplicates
you.
The one.
Duplicates
yeah.
aces. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Aces.
So you roll a good roll.
6-3.
Hitting and
moving on.
And
gets a
5-6-5.
So he needs to run out, of course.
So what about cubing here?
Wow. It's actually close to
a
redouble.
It's like a money beaver, but it's close to a redouble because of the score. Already.
I'm actually, it's even in the in the winning chances here, but just because of the score and the volatility
and it's
the,
a redouble, he has no use of the cube, and you have a very good use of your gammons.
Yeah,
so it's a close to double.
So I played 5-2, which you know, is
you hit of course.
I hit it, and then I go down to 11 instead of 10, which is
you go to the 8, but you could get another builder like this,
or
at the cost of only double fives.
Yeah.
So
I
guess
understand.
Just the extra builder.
It's close. He gets a 5-3, which is a huge joker.
Yeah, huge joker.
And should have played the other one.
Still, he would have made
fuck. This. Yeah, we would have made that, but that would have been a
still better.
Not as bad.
No,
I get and he's just, you know, too good.
Just,
no, I'm sorry, he doubled.
Already.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
I'm just, you know.
Just getting smashed. Oh, you get the anger. So now there's always a, you know, a long chance to win an ace point game.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Now you actually don't want to enter too quickly, because that you might
just run
crunch.
The board
here.
Yeah, crunch, yeah.
Okay, so I should not leave you so many shots,
maybe
fly shots.
I'm just building.
Oh,
yeah.
Place it safe.
Yeah.
Building.
Double four or something, like, I don't know, making the 9. And he gets in with those, I don't know. Yeah, small.
Yeah,
small. Yeah. Double threes. Really need the 6 soon. Not to crunch, get a double 4, which I don't know how, what's going on. Can play this, or he played. Okay, so it's pay now.
It's a bit pay now, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know.
It's just not so flexible to get a checker down here against an ace point game.
Yeah.
It's worth giving you a 6-2. You're not. It's not like you're winning when you roll the 6-2.
Yeah.
Anyway, 6-5. Good to get a 6,
really
so you
good.
Don't crunch.
Really good.
3-5
gets a bit awkward.
Yeah,
get a lots of number. I'm actually winning.
You're winning like 13%.
Yeah.
So it's not hopeless.
2-3-2. He actually
Ah, that's
he plays the three is easy because he plays 6-3. But the twos, you
again,
know,
again,
it's why not take it off?
It's pretty bad to have this checker here. You
yeah.
just want to check it off.
Yeah.
Mitch's book about the end game talks a lot about these positions.
Okay. Yeah.
So it's really good.
And now it gets also, yeah, of course, the infamous 6-5. But I roll a 6-4, which is tough because do I run or do I, like, you know?
You save a lot of gammons by running, but you the what you give up is his 6-5, which will leave a double shot if you stay here. So and the problem with staying
crunch,
is also crunching.
Yeah,
yeah, so it's
close.
It's pretty close.
5-2.
Save.
4-3.
Stay, of course. 6-2. Oh, now the hope
that's
is
good roll. Yeah, it's getting hopeless. So hopeless that I have to run because I'm now under the, you know, attack also. So
and also there's no real way of getting a shot now.
Yeah. So this is just, you know. Yeah.
Single game.
Single game.
But could have been worse. Could have been better.
Could have been better. But 5-2 here. And he's leading 10-6.
Yeah,
and
so
it's not normal, of course.
More clear than normal to split.
Yeah, he's been, otherwise, he would have been trading a lot. Perhaps 2 down could have been correct. But play 5-1.
5-1. And
double
he
fives.
Blitzes.
It's
now
totally
it's fine to blitz.
Fine without making any, you know, giving any shots or anything. 5-1. I need to slot one of the points, and
you want to
slot
my
better point,
the better point, and also unstack this one.
Yeah, yeah.
So now he.
So actually, now he is leading 10-6.
Yeah.
He's just missed. Yeah. So.
This is actually.
He decides double. Actually.
This is actually quite interesting because these are the kind of. It's what I like to call a 30-30 position. You have 30% gammons and about 30% wins. Here you have something closer to 40 actually, but these blitz positions is often around 30% gammons and often more than 30% wins for the tech side. And they are often very, very good to double in when you're trailing and very dangerous to take when you're leading. And they're often very, very dangerous to double when you're leading, because you get the other guy wins a lot of games, and you don't get as much value for your gammons.
No, you actually over.
So this is a position where, had the score been reversed, it could probably be, could be correct.
Yeah,
I would say.
So this is a huge mistake and by far the biggest mistake.
It's a score mistake
in the match, and
the position and itself is fine, but the score when you're leading 10-6, it's much too dangerous.
I love getting the cube,
and
if I redouble,
the four cube is gonna
I would actually win the game getting a redouble gammon. So
yeah, exactly.
So this is
and you still win some gammons.
Yeah.
It gives you a huge chance.
So
now he blitzes, of course, as his plan.
So now he blitzes, hits both, and
you
just
roll. And now you're already
so happy
really happy to have
know,
a two cube.
Get the cube.
And you're already considering what should I redouble.
And he gets in, and now blitzes actually
well.
This is just, you know,
it's almost
so close to a redouble.
Already here as an underdog, you can.
And
you hit.
I hit, and I play
the only ace.
Just, you know,
he hits there
back and forth, and I hit back and forth, and he hits.
Yeah, this is really a, 18 like
again.
A,
it's
this is
to
really
five,
kind of game he doesn't want when,
no,
with,
this
with you having the two cube.
And I develop, you know, an anchor, high anchor here, and
now you're
and
controlling the position pretty.
Yes, I do.
With the cube.
Yeah.
It's so pretty good for you.
4-3, I actually have to hit both because I have such a.
Ah,
so it's anchors down, you know.
And also, you're not risking much by hitting both. If you get hit, you just
get more timing on.
Recirculate. Yeah.
Recirculate, yeah.
And if he like rolls something like 6-6, you might get a get a good game.
Anyway, but it's a bit awkward roll though. But I don't know. But it's I. Anyway, so 5-2 here. It's just hitting and something. He actually could have made the 16 points, just moving on
to get them closer to him.
Yeah.
Clearing the 18.
4-1. I just slot
the 5 for sure.
5-4 is actually, it's a bit awkward. So
he should hit.
Should hit, and he does.
Yeah.
Well played.
Much stronger.
3-1.
Yeah.
I fan 6-4.
Yeah.
Down.
Get a builder now.
Move on.
Good roll.
Get a really
four.
Good roll. And he enters, and he actually hits. So it's.
No, he doesn't hit.
I'm sorry, he doesn't hit, but he plays to 23 and he saves this one. Give me a double shot here, and so he actually,
He still has a stronger board and a blitz position, so he should probably try to,
and,
to attack.
Now I have a redouble.
Already here, yeah. That
already
says
here.
Something about it. You are only a 54% favorite.
Yeah.
But the score and the recube is
the value of the cube.
He
is
has no
so
cube value when he gets
a
4 cube, almost.
I roll a 6-2, where I hit, and
you hit from the 23.
I hit from
23. Makes sense.
3.
You want some connectivity.
Yeah, and he fans.
And he fans.
And then I decide to.
And it's actually too good. It's a crazy score.
It's a crazy score.
3 away is also really.
But he wants
crazy
to justify
score.
His double, so he takes.
I would expect a take for sure.
Yeah.
Because it's such a huge money take, huge money take.
Yeah.
And when he doubled too early, then you're not gonna get a pass here. That would be because then.
Well, but
I would clearly expect a take here.
Yeah.
Also, because it's
but
it's
a pass.
only because of this score and it's a recube. It's a big pass.
Yeah.
And
mm-hmm.
actually slightly too good.
Yeah.
But good timing with the cube, the recube, because now you're happy that he's holding. You can you can equalize the score just by winning the game, and you can win the match by winning a gamma.
Yeah, I was really feeling confident here that now I really want to get the gammas out of it. But just winning at least would make an even match. So 6-1, I make the 14 point here. Double 3 is just something.
Oh,
he hits
again. Yeah, he should again blitz.
2-1 is
two
bit
one
awkward,
is a bit awkward.
I have to
luckily, you can play.
Yeah,
to the 13.
4-2 gets even better board. Double 2s here is very interesting and difficult. Often double two is difficult because you can either make the 9 point to start developing a bit of a prime and or make the 4 point, which is also very good, or something like this. I don't know why I played this, but
I think it's actually also good to keep the 20 because he can't make it.
Yeah.
And
if I get hit, it's a bit more dangerous for me, getting hit, of course. Also, if I leave the 20 point, he has a stronger ball.
Yeah, exactly. And the 9 point is just a more compact prime, so.
Mm-hmm.
Also, normally the 11 point is good when you have an open 5 point and you don't hear. So now you.
I'm not really making anything with the 11 when I have
not,
the 5 point.
Really,
yeah.
So that's probably
conceptually,
it. But it's,
it's conceptually
it's
wrong. But
it's still a bit surprising that it's such a big thing.
Yeah,
because
it
also looks natural to make the 18.
This is just also strong. Anyway, but he rolls a double 3, so he doesn't hit, and he just. Either needs to take 3 from 18 or 3 from the 13.
Oh yeah.
So that's
he should try to get them home. He's leading
close.
The race by that.
That's
yeah.
close. He decides to do the right thing according to the computer here. Clear the 18.
Yeah.
Get home.
Yes.
Double twos.
So now
no,
you make the
I make
prime.
The now I make
nice,
the prime.
Nice.
3-1 he hits.
Position.
And then I just start fanning, I think.
Now you're also a bit sad that you don't have the 20.
Yeah, exactly.
Because now we can remake the 5-1.
I'm really sad here. I'm just fanning, gets double 3.
I
fan,
slots it.
And it slots.
I know he makes it, yeah.
And it's correct. And probably there's nothing else, And I really want a 5 now. I don't get it. But he makes it with a 10.
Yeah.
With 15,
it's
so
unfortunate. So now
still, it's almost even game, but or at least the equity wise, it's more or less the same. So I still keep fanning.
He rolls an important 2.
3 and his
but
3 is awkward. He can't get up, so he has to go down there. I get the 2, And now actually...
Now you're in a really good position.
I'm in a good position. So he needs... Actually, this is crazy.
Wow.
Wow. What a find. Oh, what a move from XG.
So yeah, that's...
So he doesn't want to give a shot.
Okay.
I understand that.
This
so he plays, you know, to the five. But XG is so keen on not getting primed that...
This is actually... this is very, very difficult for a human to find.
Duplicating the fours and... but fuck, lift the six is...
Okay, it's so important not to get primed. But
would you find this?
I don't think so.
Wow.
I don't think anyone would.
No.
Or maybe I shouldn't say, but it's...
it's so tough, you know. To
also,
this.
You duplicate the force.
Yeah, exactly, duplicate the force. Yeah. But
or
still, man.
Triplicate
on
also.
Your
wow. It's a cool, cool
it's
play.
It's a cool
it's
play.
Just,
I understand
the idea
really well
is
why I didn't do that. But
you're just... you just really, really want to... step up here.
Yeah.
But this just looks so unusual to break the 6 point.
Yeah. Let's not go into the...
maybe,
we don't understand
maybe,
this,
maybe
but
I think
we understand it, but it's just, you know.
I think maybe one player that could find it is a team, a consultation team.
Uh-huh.
Might find it, actually. Yep. Like like one of those World Cup consultation matches with a strong team could find it, actually.
You win a lot more games. You
but
lose
I think
a little bit more.
It's very tough for one
damage.
Single player to find.
Yeah.
And I'm not, you know, blaming Stefan for not finding it. It's really difficult.
Not at all. 6-3 here.
You can make it. Just make
I
it.
Can make it and I make it.
Yeah, I would do that too, I think.
Although XG is disagreeing a little bit.
It's close. It
but it's so close.
But it's
but
also
like
a, you're
it
also
giving a shot, but I'm making the prime here.
I can get behind that. I think I'll make it as well. But I can also see that it can't be that bad to go to the 14 because you're only leaving four shots and you're a big favorite to make it with a double shot.
Yeah. This one here, so something going out here. Yeah.
So you make it, and he.
Anyway, I make it, and he gets a 4-2. Now it, of course, he has to step out and up, and it plays itself. And now I get a 6-1, and
okay.
Can't hit, but
at least you
can. I
can
make this
17, which is also a bit, you know,
also
a thorn in his side.
Yeah, 2-1 needs to play 6-3. 2-1, I need to slot.
Yeah,
I need to slot.
His sixes are good, so good anyway.
I can't hit here. It's just too ugly. This is
no. And if you slot, then he doesn't roll a six.
Yeah,
he
rolls
does,
a six.
Which
he does.
It
was his match.
Bad. But you still
it's
have
6-5.
It's
just such an excellent roll. Still have, you know, 23% here. So
also because you have the if you come in quickly, you still have the 17, which you can
5-1 fan 3-1. He now pays now, of course, or not paying, but of course he has to clear. While I'm on the bar, 5-4, fanning, 6-1, place safe and up there.
Yeah, start
fanning.
To clear the 6 point.
Double fives, you don't need gammons here, you just want to win.
Exactly.
And that's
clear.
Clearly.
Don't make a gap.
No, and don't make a gap. So,
yeah.
Anyway, it would probably have been wrong. Anyways, double fives, keep on fanning. Double three.
Oh, that's
a bit awkward.
Curious.
So, very awkward actually.
Yeah.
So.
Now you jump up to 28 and wins.
Yeah, I keep on fanning.
I think you're gonna win this.
He gets a 6-4. 2-1. So I enter.
Oh, that was bad that
so
he cleared.
Yeah. So but he
5-4. I think you're gonna win it.
5-4. 6-2. Anyway, so game over.
Maybe enough in these positions.
Yeah.
With one checker here.
Yeah.
XG Mobile doesn't keep
what?
The point. It doesn't see that double aces.
Not
it sees so little wins.
No,
anyway.
XG Mobile. Which
so
is actually
just,
this is, that's my favorite training tool.
Yeah,
you know,
like
playing
play.
With the tutor mode.
Yeah,
7-point matches. I just you know really yeah.
It's pretty good, but it doesn't see that it should keep the point.
But
of course
it's not
should, just
as strong as you know the.
No, it's
yeah.
a bit weaker, but not
yeah.
not that.
But
that
it's
much.
Still very strong.
Okay, so he wins the match.
He wins the match. All right. What do you? Yeah. Do you have any? Comments on?
I think there was some big cube errors, especially in the last game. And but the checker play was overall
pretty good from both of you. There was some match. Yeah, this match cube was.
Yeah. This last game here was so dangerous to be cubing when you're leading.
And there were some plays that are, you know, interesting for us humans to study, but maybe very, very difficult to find, like the you know, breaking the board in the last game.
That was like crazy things. Anyway, thanks for commenting. Yeah, good match.